Having moved from London to Udimore in Sussex 4 years ago, I decided that from time to time I would like to open up my studio and house to other like-minded printmakers. In October 2008, I ran an intensive 8-day workshop here with the help of my two printers, Dawn Cole and Nicola Jackson, and my husband, Harold Moores. The students duly arrived and the next day was spent with lectures and demonstrations. This one was focusing on embossing, using a very large print called sheets to illustrate the process. At this time I was combining etching with blind embossing using plastic to build up the plate. We also discussed various methods of constructing a collagraph plate, comparing the plates along with the prints. The students very quickly got into the swing of it, and after a couple of days experimenting with various methods of collagraph plate making, they set about getting to grips with the new and difficult printing processes involved.
But I'd like to try and get some more colour in that, if I could.
Yes, I think that would be a good idea. Yes, it is very subtle, and yeah. I think you need to have some more contrast, build some more contrast into it. Oh, now that's looking interesting. Okay, so we've got basically got a golden intaglio.
I'll just get a red.
And you're wiping it really clean.
I am.
Okay, and so are you just planning to put the three rubs on it, Anna?
I'm about to put three rubs on it, yeah.
Okay, so we've got the black and red print going through now. Carolyn over here, winding it through. Okay, Manfred, so you're going to do a print of this one. Okay, so there it is, coming out the other end, and that's it. Okay, Carrie, would you like to just come over and have a look at your
this one here.
Print here, yeah, which I thought looked splendid, sitting there when it was being uncovered by Keith.
Well, here we are out in the beautiful autumn sunshine, having a well-earned break from our very frenetic activity. We've got a lovely lunch, which you're all enjoying. Getting ourselves stoked up for the activities in the afternoon. We have had a wonderful young cook come over from New Zealand, Amber Brindle, who is doing the most splendid job. Lovely salads, and we're having a very good time. And there she is in the conservatory.
This is Amber, and she's having a well-deserved rest and eating her beautiful salad that looks so lovely on her plate. Now here we have a discussion of materials between the two men who are great at finding all sorts of interesting things to print with.
Yeah.
So what have you actually got there then?
It's an open scrim, but it's got an adhesive, slight taffy adhesive on the back.
Oh, okay. Well, that's useful for collagraphs. Okay.
I'm just putting on my red rubs now.
Right.
Dawn's just been helping with the arm movement. It was very helpful to know.
Yes.
Not to twist, but to have the whole hand of arms.
Yes, that looks much better, yeah. And you're doing it very gently. Okay. So here we go.
Okay, well, here goes, nothing.
Okay.
Right,
let's see how this is coming out.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's very
wonderful.
Exciting.
Oh,
terrific.
Wow.
Oh, well done, Keith.
Yeah, bring it
thank
here,
you.
Keith.
It
looks great.
Look at this, it's the cake.
Well, here, this is the last night, and we're having an exhibition and a critique in the Oast House at Fowler House.
It was really good to see, as the week developed, you were thinking about doing using those techniques to actually suit you, and I can't say how how good it's been having this group. I think you've been just great.
Thank you.
What's nice about this is that it's basically a very, it's a black and white print, but you've just got a little bit of colour coming in, which I think gives it quite a lot of lift. Right, Jane, these two prints here, I think you've come a long way in the time that you've been experimenting. There's a lovely subtlety about these two, I think. They're quite simple and formalised, and the... there's a kind of glow about them.
I was very pleased with the way the silver leaf just stuck on.
It is nice with them.
It was with scrim and with
you put the silver leaf on with the scrim over the top, and I think that it does work very nicely.
Carrie, I saw this in its early stages, and I thought, I really like that.
Yeah. And it went through several metamorphoses, didn't it? Do you want to tell them about how that developed?
What I discovered here is plaster, which I've never used before. Oh. And that's really just opened my eyes to giving a textural surface. And it's slightly accidental, but I made up lots of plaster plates, and then I kind of looked at some of the shapes that had been were emerging from them. So I didn't
really just
know,
enhanced
yes,
the shapes.
Yes, so I didn't really know what was going to happen. And this one seemed to have a face and a figure. And it just seemed to turn into this. And then the oven that I've discovered is Hammerite. and just the, you know, it's like when you make people puddings at home and you're doing this wonderful effect.
It flows beautifully.
And just I love to go with the materials and see what the materials do.
Yes.
And so I've kind of been led very much by what you've given, you know, what's been on the floor. Yeah. So this Hammerite, which gives this wonderful twinkly, you know, lines.
Yes.
And then to polish it with a tissue, this, you know, so it gets whiter and whiter.
I think
it
really is.
It's just
kind of pattern. Could be a pattern of a dress, could be autumn leaves, who knows?
Yes.
But it actually really makes the whole thing come alive. It's very nice. This one here, the scoring into plaster, was it? The scoring into plaster?
Quite exciting. And I love Greek and Roman sculptures. When I love going to museums, I love the still white shapes.
Yes.
And the fact that they're sculptural, and I've now found a medium that's sculptural.
Yes.
In which I can represent them. And I think that's very exciting. It's lovely.
He has done very
Absolutely.
He's done a very good image there. I think he was very pleased, even though he wasn't able to stay till the end.
Keith tore his mount board dramatically to form amazing edges. And that's the top one. The second, the bottom one, I used plant materials which I embedded in PVA mainly, grasses and bits of leaf at the bottom there.
I mean, this is terrific, strong. It really works very well. And that's the plant material. And with various rubs and all that sort of thing done. But what she did do was she decided it was all a little bit sort of, it just needed tying together and making stronger, I think. And I don't think I've suggested that to you, did I?
No, but you think you've got in the border, right?
Yeah,
no, that's from watching your videos today. That's what inspired. Indirectly, as far as
And doing the, you know, the inked up one and the one that's just blind embossed. But livening it up with a drawing on the wall.
I think it's great, it's so fresh.